chance for us to give a tribute to you dads out there who make life tremendous for all those kiddies out there all year long. A chance for us to say thank you to you and you, Brain, knowing the modus operandi of your family. What is your dad getting for you? A yacht, perhaps?
No.
How about a new car?
No.
Stocks and bonds?
No.
Cash money?
No, Monsoon. My father does not operate that way.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
Father's Day comes and Father's Day goes. And all my life on Father's Day, the biggest day of my year, you think he'd get me anything?
Of your year?
He's an ingrate. He's a bum. Every time Father's Day comes, nothing. On Mother's Day, Mom gets me all kinds of stuff. Mercedes is next. But you think he'd get me something? No. We walk into a restaurant. They don't say, hey, there's Ivan Heenan. They say, no, there's Bobby the Brain's dad. He's been coasting off my reputation all my life. But no, on Father's Day, he doesn't get me anything.
Boy, am I glad to hear that. A special tribute just for you, Pop Heenan. Your kid's a fraud, and you know it. Here we go. This week on WWF Cavalcade, dedicated to Father's Day, in our special report, another crybaby, Ric Flair.
Well, having Ric Flair here is present enough for me. And we're also going to be seeing the debut of the man who put the big boss man in solitary confinement forever. I'm talking about Nails.
Texas Tornado is on hand.
And the giant from Uganda, Kamala.
The Rockin' Owen Hart and his partner, Coco Beware. High energy is here. Let's get to ringside. And your left brain jam-packed to the rafters.
Making his way through the ring. Weighing
for this WWF event.
Here it is.
Take a good look. This could just about be probably the strongest man in the WWF.
All right, I guess you got your boat in the water already. Being that this is the first weekend of summer, got that yacht floating around out there that your mom gave you.
Well, I deserved it. Here in America, you know, with Father's Day approaching, I don't want to talk about it.
You catch it, don't you? Get all choked up.
I understand.
You know, it's not like I don't deserve something. You don't. You deserve absolutely what you get. Nothing. What a future this youngster's got in store for himself.
He had a little different change of attitude, and I was back at managing. Boy, could I make a bundle.
Boy, could you take him to the cleaners.
No, I mean for both of us.
His speed to get around the big guy. You know, Joe Louis once said you can run, but you can't hide. And sooner or later, he's going to catch up to Horowitz.
You're just going to make him mad.
Look at that look.
Look at that.
He caught that punch in midair.
And he's crushing his hand with one hand.
Military press time for Mr. Horowitz.
It's like the inside of a cheap watch.
I thought he was going to dump him in about the 18th row.
He can do it. I think the secret to wrestling him is to get in the ring with Crush and try to out-wrestle. You don't want to get this guy mad.
I would just send in a note. Look at that back.
How tall you think he's? About 6'7", 6'8"?
At least 6'8".
He's over 300 pounds, too. You know, like some of the other wrestlers say he's a real nice guy.
What's wrong with that?
The nice guy finished last.
Oh, yeah? I don't think Crush will be finishing last. Look at that agility.
He's got a heck of a future here. He's agile. He's strong.
What's he doing up there?
Knocking people down.
Uh-oh.
It's time for the compactor, I think.
The cranium crunch is coming up. And Horowitz won't like it. Take a look, ref, because I don't think he can speak.
and mashed potatoes on Horowitz.
Boy, that didn't take long.
The last time you heard a man yell like that in pain.
Rush, what a very impressive victory here this week on Wrestling Challenge. You can bet we're going to be seeing a whole lot more of this youngster.
What's he doing now? He's going to rip his head off now.
He is not. He's giving a little acknowledgement here to Barry Horowitz, who can't even stand on his own two feet.
Special report with all kinds of good stuff coming up. Stop.
Hello, everyone. This week's special report is brought to you by the WWF magazine, which will be on sale this Tuesday at newsstands everywhere. Now, last week on WWF, my colleague Meet Gene Oakland had the distinct honor of talking with the World Wrestling Federation champion, Macho Man, Randy Savage. And it soon became crystal clear that the champion's focus is absolutely unshakable. The title is still firmly held in his steely grasp, and his intention is it will stay there. Here is that tenacious champion, Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Now, when I wrestle scientific wrestlers, I can do it that style, too. And I can keep my World Wrestling Federation championship belt. But when I know ahead of time, not being naive, mean Gene Oakland, I've never been that.
No.
Never been that. That a person is the dirtiest player to ever play the game, then I do what I have to do. So that at the end, the bottom line is that I walk out with the World Wrestling Federation championship belt.
The champion Randy Savage reasserting his own convictions. However, vociferously opposed to the champion's reign is the flamboyant one, Ric Flair. Here he is, along with his executive consultant, Mr. Perfect.
You know, Slick Rick, some men do what they have to win championships. Well, Savage, there's nothing you can do. You've been outclassed, outmatched, out-knowledged, you're done.
Don't ever make the mistake of comparing me to any other wrestler. I'm the dirtiest player in the game. And what I say goes. And right now, I'm looking towards my second reign as the World Wrestling Federation champion. Woo!
The pasta.
They loved it.
The sauces.
Yes, great.
The cooking.
So easy.
Introducing McCain Pasta Magic. Simply microwave the sauce, run the frozen pasta under hot water for a few seconds, and magically, tender, just right pasta. Combine them for perfect pasta and perfect sauce.
Fettuccine.
Alfredo.
Pasta salad.
My next shopping.
New McCain Pasta Magic. Delicious, perfectly prepared pasta and sauce in less than 3 minutes.
It's magic.
It's McCain.
Welcome to Party TV, the great Canadian party, and welcome Spinal Trap. Spinal Tap.
Hello, Canada.
So, your tour starts July 1st?
And ends July 1st. St. John's, Toronto, and Vancouver, all in one day.
Big birthday celebration.
That's right.
Whose birthday?
Canada's.
Country can't have a birthday. Country's not born, it's formed.
By geopolitical forces.
Yes.
Well, it's going to be a big party, 100,000 people.
See, I can have a birthday because I was born.
Yes.
Not formed.
Right.
Yes.
Spinal Tap, the interview. More to come.
It's like Poland.
Yes.
Poland.
Okay, let's give this tune-up thing the old college try, shall we? Goodyear means...
Tune-ups, I tell you. That's what Goodyear means.
Oh, that was spontaneous. People talking about Goodyear's growing reputation for excellent tune-ups in their very own words. But let's try it again. Goodyear means...
Goodyear, you say? I think of tune-ups.
This is really gratifying.
Goodyear. From tune-ups to tires.
I feel so... What's the word?
Cheap?
Cheap. Right, thank you.
Take a look, it's coming your way. Take a look at the best thing going. The spirit, the style, mile after mile. Take a look at the train today. Take a look, you'll like what you see. Take a look and set yourself free. The service, the style, mile after mile. Take a look at the train today.
WWF in your area. Sunday, August 16th, the WWF will be in Peterborough, Ontario.
Saturday, August 15th, Sudbury, Ontario hosts the WWF. Friday, August 14th, the WWF visits Thunder Bay, Ontario. Also on Friday, August 14th, the WWF visits London, Ontario. Thursday, August 13th, Kingston, Ontario welcomes the WWF. Thursday, July 23rd, the WWF will be in St. John's, Newfoundland. Wednesday, July 22nd, Moncton, New Brunswick welcomes the WWF. Sunday, July 12th, Toronto, Ontario's Maple Leaf Gardens hosts the WWF. Sunday, June 28th, the WWF visits Newmarket, Ontario. Saturday, June 27th, Fredericton, New Brunswick welcomes the WWF. Friday, June 26th, the WWF will be in Montreal, Quebec.
Boy, what a blessing to have someone representing the World Wrestling Federation like the Macho Man, Randy Savage. That's off to you, Randy.
Yeah, the Macho Chief. That's what I like to call him.
Man has to represent the United States of America, represent the world, represent children, represent adults, represent the WWF, and he's nothing but a cheat.
And doing it
very nicely, isn't he?
I've had it up to here with Macho Cheat.
The Beverley Brothers!
These two gentlemen right here own the Legion of Sissies. The what? That's what they told me. Well, the genius told me. Bowen Blake, the Beverleys, under the tutelage of Mr. Garbage personified, the
and
genius.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the genius!
Oh, boy.
My favorite part.
Shh. Sarcastic happy Father's Day, you sissy L.O.D. I'll bet your daddies still aren't sure if you're a he or she. I guarantee you he came out of a tube somewhere. A test tube. Greatest advertisement for birth control I've ever seen in my life. The genius.
You're just jealous because you had a son like that.
Oh, boy. Boy, I wouldn't want to wish that on anybody.
Carry on the great Monsoon name.
Oh, please.
Could have had your own little spider monkey.
Yeah. He reminds me sometimes of a monkey. He can do some tricks.
He is acrobatic.
Bo and Blake perhaps have bitten off more than they can chew. We'll take a phone to find out. Here they are, three beauties.
A riddle from the genius. What does the Legion of Doom have in common with Father's Day?
Absolutely nothing. A matter of fact, their fathers are very disappointed. Well, certainly they were. They wanted two little boys. But what they got were two sissy girls.
These guys are going to end up getting maimed. Do you know that? Does the word maimed convey anything to you, Brain?
Yeah, I've been to Portland.
No, not Portland, Maine. I'm talking about maimed.
You mean as in very, very badly beaten up?
That's correct.
You better talk to the boss man about that. Or nails. Barry, you think L.O.S. is going to do a number?
L.O. who?
L.O.S.
L.O.S.
Well, Beverly said as long as I'm doing the color on their match, I'm going to refer to L.O.S. as the Legion of
Sissies. I'll remind Animal and Hawk
I'm
about
just
that.
Doing my job.
Yeah. Well, they'll do their job on you.
I mean no harm to anyone, Monsoon.
Uh-oh. What a header.
That's using your head.
It's all over. It won't be that easy pickings with Animal and Hawk.
I think it's time to do some painting.
What do you mean by that?
You watch and see. I think the genius has some paint there, and there's the brush.
What's the matter? Didn't they have any toys when they were kids? Or they're still kids? That's the problem.
Those look a little bit like Animal. L-O-S. What does that spell?
Legion of Sissies. Now tell everybody at home who the Legion of Sissies are.
Edition of the WWF Spotlight Magazine, available on newsstands everywhere, on the cover, the big guy, The Undertaker. In fact, the entire edition devoted exclusively to The Undertaker. Let's go back up the ringside. Get your hands off my spotlight.
You see the magazine.
You want one? Go buy one.
Cheapskate. Why would I do that? I mean, the guy's a detective. That tells you something right there.
And how would you know what kind of intelligence he has?
Well, I've talked to people from Texas. It's all yup and yip and stuff like that.
Oh, they are nuts. Get serious.
It's a different country. Get in the ring, stupid.
He'll get in when he's good and ready. Gets in there a lot quicker than Flair does, I'll tell you that.
When you're Ric Flair, you make your own time.
Yeah. A picture's worth a thousand words, lady, and snap a good one. Bob Bradley supplying the opposition here this week for our Texas Tornado.
Bradley's a tough competitor.
He certainly is. Although he's given away what? 60, 70 pounds. Kind of tough to do that and give away that experience and the weight and expect to come out on top. Highly unlikely. Another thing that's highly unlikely is that Flair will ever regain the WWF title.
Oh, just throw that in, yeah.
What it was worth.
Yeah, rub a little salt in the wound, Monsoon.
Just happened to come up and
just pop out of your mouth, yeah.
Conversation.
Oh, it's gonna happen. It'll happen soon.
Oh, look at this.
Whoa, good move, Bradley.
Wow, he's got the Tornado's attention now. Look at those right hands. One after the other.
Well, he hurt his hand on that one.
He might have. That Bradley's got a hard head.
He punched him 25 times.
A duck underneath by Tornado. Look out. Clothesline City.
He took him down. That was a full clothesline.
Uh-oh. Whirling Dervish coming up. There it is. The City Texas Tornado down for the cover. One, two, three. It's all over just like that.
He almost screwed himself into the mat.
Whoa. Holy mackerel. Chuck one up in the wind column. For the Texas Tornado.
Good afternoon, sports fans. Billy Red here once again. And, of course, another reminder of that action-packed card coming up in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens on Sunday, July the 12th, with all the action getting underway at 7:30 p.m. In the big main event, tag team action, Ultimate Warrior, along with The Undertaker, taking on the mysterious Papa Shango and the Berserker. Last week, we heard from the Big Boss Man in a telephone interview. He said he would be back, and he will be back. Just signed this past week, Big Boss Man in a one-on-one going against Nails. Also in tag team action, the Legion of Doom, Animal and Hawk, going up against the Beverley Brothers. Let's bring in both teams for their comments.
You know, the genius's good friend, Dr. Sigmund Ziff, had the Legion of Sissies psychoanalyzed, and he came to this conclusion. Their parents really wanted two little girls, and they got their wish. You see, when they were younger, they wore funny haircuts and makeup, and they still do. But that's not going to cut it here in the World Wrestling Federation when you got two men like the Beverley Brothers standing in your way. And that's why you still are the Legion of Sissies.
There's a new world order in the WWF, and it's the Legion of Doom on top. And Beverleys, you're going down on the bottom. Come, Animal.
Well, Beverley Brothers, I'll give you credit. The genius will take you places. Maybe. But we're going to see who you call sissies when we knock your stinking teeth down your throat. You won't be able to call us nothing. Tell them, Hawk.
Well, you can say goodbye to that rich and pampered life you've been leading, because now you've led yourself down a dirt road with a dead end. And at the end of the dead end is the Legion of Doom. You don't like it? We don't care.
And after the following messages, we'll be back with the Ugandan giant, Kamala.
Hey, destructive forces at work in your engine. Heat and friction. But there is a way to fight back. Pennzoil Premium Quality Motor Oil. Pennzoil defines performance.
Okay, we're back. Guys, the whole country is talking about your one-day Canadian tour.
Yeah, we'll need a limo.
Limo?
From St. John's to Vancouver.
We're renting a plane.
Yeah, but there's still some empty seats on it.
Yeah, so we're doing a contest.
The winners get to party with us on the plane.
Well, we do need a skill testing question. How about this? In your song, Clam Caravan, where are the clams?
Rodney clams.
Well, now you've given it away.
We can't ask that. It's a trick question.
You got a better one? Final tap, the interview.
Who is Bobo the dog?
Question should be about us. Should be about the band, yeah.
This is an ordinary run-of-the-mill exhaust pipe. And this is a Midas Long Life exhaust pipe. It's aluminized. And for about the same price, it lasts twice as long as ordinary pipe. And for most cars, only Midas makes it.
Mellow. Are you kidding? If you look up Mellow in the dictionary, you'll find my picture.
This is an ordinary run-of-the-mill exhaust pipe. And this is a Midas Long Life exhaust pipe. It's aluminized. And for about the same price, it lasts twice as long as ordinary pipe. And for most cars, only Midas makes it.
Take a minute now, listen to me. Rent for 2 weekends, the third one's free.
Just rent a car for any 2 weekends, and your third weekend's free.
Say hello to Razor Ramon. Check my ride, man. He's a Cadillac, man. Custom made for Razor. You know, Chico, 90 miles away, they're living like pigs. They're living in squalor, man. They're eating garbage. People telling them what to do. Nobody telling Razor Ramon what to do, man. Nobody. I coming to the WWF. Nobody going to stop me. Nobody going to tell Razor Ramon what to do. El Jefe. Razor Ramon.
I wouldn't exactly buy a used car from Razor.
Hey, he's a sharp guy.
Kind of like a sleaze bag to me.
Oh, watch this, watch this.
I like Razor. I think he's got a lot of style.
Yeah. Harvey Whippleman.
Here's a guy with a lot of class. It's all low, though, unfortunately.
You know, when I first came to the World Wrestling Federation, I said that I was here to take over. And now, after searching through deepest, darkest Africa, my friend Jim Shee has helped me find the man that will enable me to own the WWF.
Uh-oh.
Now, escorted by the great Jim Shee, here is the Ugandan giant, the mighty Kamala.
Well, it's too bad, Harvey, that something didn't suck you up while you were over there in Africa and Egypt. Give me
like a tiger?
Or a big fat snake?
And his opponent, weighing in 227 pounds and hailing from Las Vegas, Nevada, here is Reno Riggins.
Take a look at the look on Riggins' kisser.
You know, I hate to say it, but Kamala looks better with his mask on than McGurk does.
Oh, will you stop?
Is that some kind of tribal heritage? Does that signify the tribe he's from or something? Or
what, the mask?
Yeah, what does that mean? And all those half moon and the
it's
stars?
It's just an African mask. Can't you just leave it at that?
Well, I'm a broadcast journalist. I need to... Uh-oh.
There's the tribal distinctive marks right there on his kisser.
Look, there is no style to this man. He just goes after you. Uh-oh, dinner time.
Kimchi just said something. Could you make it out?
Not. Well, I didn't hear it good.
He says I need two more missionaries to go. I'll tell you what, he didn't learn that reverse thrust kick in the jungle.
Is this man a savage or not?
Boy, is he unorthodox.
Look at the size. He's got to have 15, 18-inch ankles.
18-inch ankles?
Look at the size of the ankles on him. Whoa!
Oh. That'll break your back.
No, you got to turn him over.
But see, he's a foreigner. They should allow him to beat the man like that.
Well, how about those two deadbeats he's got with him? They're not foreigners.
I don't know where Kimchi's from or who he's from or what he is or if he's even an American.
Event center coming up. Here we go.
Another one of the exciting matches you'll be seeing on Sunday, July 12th in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens is a one-on-one confrontation between El Matador Tito Santana, the young man that can do it all, and the Ugandan giant Kamala. And, of course, the big one that everyone is talking about, tag team action, Ultimate Warrior and The Undertaker taking on Papa Shango and Berserker. Let's bring in both teams for their comments.
Hush. July 12th, Hush. Maple Leaf Garden, Toronto, Hush. Canada.
Hush. Undertaker Warrior, when I'm throwing you two around, when I'm throwing you on the cement, when I'm grabbing chairs, and when I see you going down, and if you don't go down... I'm gonna use the sword on ya! And you better be able to duck, because I'm going for your heads. Ultimate Hush. Warrior, Undertaker, Hush. Me, and the Berserker Hush. Have got a surprise for you. You better be ready, because the power of voodoo, the power Hush. Of Berserker, Hush. Is coming down Hush. On you.
Hush! Hush! Hush!
Most certainly, Papa Shango and Berserker in Toronto on July 12th. You can be guaranteed there shall be ones with birthdays. There shall be ones that will have celebrations. And there shall be a wake. For in Toronto, Papa Shango, reversal of the curse of voodoo put upon me. As the Undertaker, the man that walks with death, not behind, not in front, with death, shall turn the whole situation into a funeral. The Warrior, the Reaper, locked in mortal combat, from the skies above to the ashes below. Now come together. Come together to put an end to the sorcerer and the maniac once.
And we'll be right back with El Matador, Tito Santana, after the following messages.
Chaps Comedy Club, tomorrow.
Q107 presents the Aaron Mack Trans Am Weekend at Mosport, June 26, 27, and 28. GM, Ford, and Chrysler will duke it out for the first time since the 60s when Canada's Ron Fellows and the Mustang takes on Scott Sharp and the Camaro and the Archer Brothers in Dodge Daytonas. It sounds like NASCAR's come to the Aaron Mack Trans Am. It's the Aaron Mack Trans Am Weekend at Mosport, just 2 hours from Hamilton on June 26, 27, and 28. Children under 12 and camping are free. Tickets at Becker's, Ticketmaster, and at the gate.
Oh, all right, I'm driving along. All of a sudden, right here, pow!
A rock, a piece of gravel, a deal.
And I've got trouble. I tried scrubbing it out.
Then I realized I could just take it into Speedy Auto Glass.
Boing!
You know what these are?
Trained professionals.
Over 160 locations.
You'd be cracked to go anywhere else. Cracked!
But if you can't go to them, they'll come to you.
If that happens to you, Speedy Auto Glass. Hello, crack! Get it? Thank you. Good night.
Heat pasteurizing and no preservatives. All it needed was a new shape. New Labatt Genuine Drafts in the 30-sided can.
Our latest penny fry specials are guaranteed to make you smile.
Harvey's introduces the Mushroom Swiss, tasty mushroom sauce and processed Swiss cheese. And the Chicken Club, charbroiled with processed cheddar and crisp bacon. Order either and get a regular order of French fries for just a penny.
You're still topping any way you want, but bring in your smile and an extra penny and you'll get penny fries.
Beautiful choice, beautiful values.
A loving marriage.
All the things that come so easily to Michael, were you one of them? Because there's no man that deserves that much good fortune.
A perfect life.
Karen needs to feel protected. See, she doesn't feel safe with you.
Stay away from her. Now, someone they trusted.
Man, that guy's after my wife.
Is tearing their world apart.
How do I get a cop off my back?
Get out! Unlawful Entry starts Friday, June 26th at theaters everywhere.
There's my music. I love that tune, Brain. Time for the run of the bull. When was the last time you spent a night in Tacoma, right?
Never.
Oh, have you ever been there?
Yeah.
Didn't we go down there one time?
No.
When you wouldn't get on the bus?
Or eat that sandwich you tried to get
me?
No, that was someplace else. That was over by Arizona someplace. Matamoros or someplace. Or Bad Mattress, I don't know.
One of the premier athletes here in the World Wrestling Federation. A reputation precedes him. Former Intercontinental Champion. Co-holder on several different occasions of the WWF Tag Team Championship belts. I'll tell you one thing, since he's taken up bullfighting and went to that school and learned his heritage and his roots and everything that he needs to know.
Roots. It's roots.
No, it's roots.
No, it's roots.
No, roots is that movie.
Oh, will you stop?
I thought you were an educated person.
I am.
At least that's what you would have us believe. Anyway, he's a lot quicker than he used to be.
He's quick.
He's quicker than he was a couple years ago. It seems like that bullfighting did something to him.
Yeah, it makes you get out of the way in a hurry.
Sure does. To do it good was crossing the L.A. freeway. Ball fight. Oh. Keep moving fast. Was trying to cross the L.A. freeway rush hour on foot. That'll keep you hopping.
What are you saying?
Blindfolded. Blindfolded? On those little roller blades.
I'd like to see your guy do that, or make an attempt to do that.
Or do anything for that matter.
I don't have
mind to cry. Like a little kid that someone took his lollipop. Oh. Break of the eye stops the momentum of El Matador, Tito Santana. Oh, look at that. Inverted atomic drop finds the mark.
See how quick he is? Tom Stone climbed on that second rope. He was going to work over Tito a bit. Never got the opportunity. Tito knew what he was going to do.
It's called premonition and experience, right?
There's no excuse for experience.
No substitute.
And no excuse. Oh, there it is. Uh-oh, Del Peso, Del Paso.
No. Please. You know, if you keep your mouth shut, nobody will know how dumb you are. It's all over.
They know.
Del Paso, Del Monte laid on this youngster, and the lights went out.
Start pumping the antacids. Tito's coming home for dinner, Mom.
Edition of the WWF magazine, currently on newsstands everywhere. Take a look inside. Personality profile on one Sergeant Slaughter.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week, accompanied by Sensational Sherry, here is Shawn Michaels.
I think he's cute. He's so sexy. He's got the look.
Take a look at this, won't you?
I am looking.
What do we see? The front and back of Shawn Michaels, he calls it a mirror. Geez, Gene Okerlund is likely to see his reflection in the mirror, too.
I don't even know if he has one. Michaels, you've got to be kidding me. You're having Sherry carry around a mirror so you could admire yourself? Sherry, don't you think that's a little vain?
Mirror, mirror in my hand. Who is the sexiest man in the land?
Oh, I am looking at him. Did you say vain? I thought I heard vain.
Wait a minute, I think I alluded to vanity, yes.
Did you say vain? Gene Okerlund, is it vain to want to look at what everybody in the World Wrestling Federation is talking about? I don't think so. I mean, come on now. I mean, really, who can blame them? Take a look at that. Is that not the hottest thing you have ever, ever laid eyes on?
Oh, it's on fire, all right.
You know, Mean Gene, Shawn Michaels is without a doubt the sexiest and hottest man in the World Wrestling Federation. But besides that, besides all of that, do you want to know what else I see?
Whoa, wait a minute. What in the world do you see in here?
What I see right now is the next Intercontinental Champion.
Me too.
Speaking of Bret the Hitman Hart, Shawn Michaels, you will have an opportunity to become the Intercontinental Champion here in the World Wrestling Federation. And I suggest that that would be the opportunity of a lifetime for you.
Why would a guy that looks like that worry one bit about Bret the Hitman Hart? Give me a break. You know something? I am really surprised. I gotta be honest with you. I'm surprised that they didn't beef up security here today. I mean, the people could be tearing down the barricades at any minute.
After all, Shawn Michaels is still in the building, right?
That's right. After all, Shawn Michaels is in the building. But you know, before long, Shawn Michaels won't need this mirror to see his reflection. No siree. I'll be looking at my reflection in the shiny new Intercontinental belt. Hey, did you hear that, Gene?
Yeah.
You hear all those screams? And you hear those screams? I'm telling you what, this may not be safe. They could be tearing down the barricades at any minute. All these ladies here are going to be crashing the barricades just to get a chance.
What if we can conduct the remainder of this interview?
No. In the interest of my own personal safety, I think it's time that Shawn Michaels leave the building. But before I go, I just want to say one thing. Here's looking at you, kid.
He's the most conceited individual I believe I have ever seen, but he could be the next Intercontinental Champion.
Is the place for different, like our four new subs, Italian-style cold cuts, fresh-sliced Arby's roast beef, great-tasting turkey, or delicious tuna. And if you don't think they're the best subs you've ever tasted, after just one bite, you get your money back.
Same, Arby's is different.
Hey, different is good.
This summer, we bring you the best in golf. The best players, the best tournaments, and your best shot to win the ultimate Canadian golf vacation for you and three friends to play three of Canada's premier golf courses. For your chance to win, enter the Blue Light Golf Sweepstakes at participating golf clubs and sporting goods stores.
To your windshield, a piece of gravel might look like this big rock.
That's a cracked windshield. How long have you been driving around with this chip in your windshield?
Who am I calling?
Speedy Auto Glass.
Is that what you want? I don't think you want that.
What do you think? You need a tow truck to take us into Speedy Auto Glass?
Hundreds and hundreds of windshields. Done.
No, you just drive it in.
Speedy Auto Glass. Boom.
So if this was your TV set, you'd have it replaced.
Keep the car. Repair the windshield.
Can they? Done. Yes, they can.
Remington Microscreen shaves as close as a blade. Quick, comfortable. Shaves as close as a blade or your money back. Attaboy. That's Remington.
Taking off. Nasty feels where you're going. High energy. You're gonna be
be short-circuited when you meet these two cats right here from Allentown, PA. Yeah.
Allentown, where's that? Is that near Bethlehem?
You mean the Holy Land?
No, Bethlehem, Pennsylvania.
Oh. You really know your geography, don't you, Brian?
At the back of my hand.
Oh, yeah.
The Rocket, Owen Hart, not afraid to do those high-risk moves.
Brother of Bret Hart, the Hitman.
Look at that! What the heck of a move!
That's a little drop kick. That's hard to do in baggy pants.
Coco's torn, turned on Owen Hart.
Swing shot here by Coco. He just took out the 8 and 9 pins. 7-10 split. People in those pants. I'm telling you.
Uh-oh, look at this.
Look at that.
Oh, drop kick. Oh. A beautiful move.
He's out.
Right off the shoulders of the Rocket.
He's not going anywhere.
Him out.
He's not going anywhere.
Holy mackerel.
And that's hard to do wearing Andre's old pants.
Can.
See if that sucker can fly.
Well, that bird will outlive you, Brain, that's for sure.
Birds don't live long, you know.
Parrots, are you kidding? They live to be 100 or better.
Not in my neighborhood.
Let's go back and take a look at the high flyers.
Now, look at this move, Monsoon. A double drop kick, 1 foot on each man. That's hard to do. But did Coco nail him with that drop kick?
The big WWF Championship was last weekend. Let's take a look at what went down.
What would Kamala do with the bird?
The 1992 World Bodybuilding Federation Championship kicked off with a bang as 12 Rip and Venus WWF superstars muscled it out for the coveted WWF title.
Presents the World Bodybuilding Federation Championship!
Lex Luger, recuperating in a hospital, watched on pay-per-view and saw what has got to be the most spectacular bodybuilding event in history. A giant killer. Plenty of rock and roll. Why, we even got a good look at the future. And a whole lot more. Then, after the top five finalists turned the pose down into a showdown, only one man remained. Stridham retained his championship and skyrocketed to the 1992 World Bodybuilding Federation title.
Just like an old friend, you can count on and trust. It's like smoking on the sunshine.
You'll find more things than ever to paint or protect now that Trim Clad is faster drying, longer lasting, and comes in 6 new decorator colors.
Give it that T.S.
Thank you. sale of the year is here. Everything in the store, 10 to 60% off. During Sporting Life, biggest sale of the year. Our biggest sale of the year is here. Everything in the store, 10 to 60% off. During Sporting Life, biggest sale of the year.
Tied to the telephone?
Hello, hello.
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 Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
Hello.
Yo, Johnny.
Hello?
Yes, hi.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello?
Why not let the telephone wait for you? The Mac Pager from McLean Hunter Paging.
Good, good. Brilliant.
Get the message?
Hello?
Available at the Business Depot.
Take a look. It's coming your way. Take a look at the best thing going. The spirit, the style, mile after mile. Take a look at the train today. Take a look. Take a look. You'll like what you see. Take a look.
WWF in your area. Sunday, August 16th, the WWF will be in Peterborough, Ontario. Saturday, August 15th, Sudbury, Ontario hosts the WWF. Friday, August 14th, the WWF visits Thunder Bay, Ontario. Also on Friday, August 14th, the WWF visits London, Ontario. Thursday, August 13th, Kingston, Ontario welcomes the WWF. Thursday, July 23rd, the WWF will be in St. John's, Newfoundland. Wednesday, July 22nd, Moncton, New Brunswick welcomes the WWF. Sunday, July 12th, Toronto, Ontario's Maple Leaf Gardens hosts the WWF. Sunday, June 28th, the WWF visits Newmarket, Ontario. Saturday, June 27th, Fredericton, New Brunswick welcomes the WWF. Friday, June 26th, the WWF will be in Montreal, Quebec.
Well, here's what you've been waiting for.
This is what I've been waiting for.
Curling the ring, weighing at 220 pounds, here is Dan Robbins. And his opponent.
Look at that. He's got the big boss man's club.
Making his ring, weighing in at 302 pounds, here is Nails.
A hush has sort of fallen over this arena.
Everyone is just awed, this man,
as this convicted felon makes his way down to the ring.
He was an innocent man. He was framed.
How do you know that?
I heard he was framed.
You heard. Do you have any documents to prove that?
I'm going to work on it.
Yeah.
He's got the boss man's own nice stick. Look at this.
I'm going to find out what this guy was in for.
Knowing the big boss man,
guarantee it wasn't forgery.
Probably jaywalking, and he just took advantage of the guy. Look at that.
He is a powerhouse. I guess those prison groceries agreed with him.
It may have been 400 pounds. Who knows?
Look at that. Trying to rip open the face.
I mean,
Dan Robbins.
Did you see the pictures last week? I mean, he beat the boss man. He gave him the worst beating anyone in the World Wrestling Federation has ever received.
Yeah, but what did the boss man say, Brain? I'll be back.
Yeah, but you know as well as I, if he's that dumb to even try to come back, he's not going to be 100%. And when Nails worked him over before, he was 100%. Now, if Nails gets his hands on him again, it could be curtains for the big boss man. He'd be going up the river for the last time, pal.
Don't you think that he knows that? Don't you think that he's got any pride?
Oh, look at those kicks. This man doesn't care about anybody. Shows no expression on his face. He is just one cruel individual.
Yeah, especially when he can get you while you're not looking.
Now what's he going to do?
Oh, what an awesome display of power. I don't think I've ever seen that before.
This Robbins has no idea where he's at.
He's in dreamland right now.
The most humane thing he could have done, ref, is ring that bell.
Nails!
That's the name he got when he was up at the big house, Nails.
Now, what's his real name?
Well, he didn't get that because he's a carpenter. He's got nice toes.
You don't know, do you, Frank? You're skirting the question. There's the big boss man's nightstick.
Hey, boss man used to do that, and you liked it. Now the shoe's on the other foot.
Take a look at what this sadistic individual is doing to this youngster. Hey, he hasn't shown me, Brain, any wrestling skills. It's just brute force that this convicted felon is annihilating people with.
He's terrifying, I'll tell you. He's just one big, tough, rugged man. He doesn't care if he wins or loses. He doesn't care about the rules. I doubt if he knows all the rules.
I'm surprised he's leaving.
He's just sadistic.
No expression on his face. Who knows what's going through that warped mind after spending who knows how many days in solitary confinement, what that could do to you mentally.
And think, he's an innocent man.
Please. Event center coming up. Here we go.
Billy Red here once again, and I have standing by at this time with their comments, High Energy, Owen Hart, and the Birdman, Coco Beware.
Hey, you know what, fat boys? That's right, you nasty boys. You know why they call us High Energy? It's because we're moving, we're grooving, and we're always going to the top. The Birdman and the Rocket. You want a piece of High Energy? Come and find us. Tell them about it, Birdman.
High Energy! That's what the world is talking about. High energy. I'm telling you, we got the nasty boys looking for high energy. We got DiBiase and the RS looking for high energy. That's what the World Wrestling Federation is all about. High energy. Isn't that right, Rocky?
That's right, you know, Birdman. I'll tell you something, nasty boys. You may be mean, you may be rough and tough, but don't sell high energy short because we're going straight to the top.
And now to my final guest today, the Ugandan giant, Kamala. And, of course, he's accompanied by his manager, Harvey Whippleman.
Texas Tornado. You're a great wrestler. You've got a great body. But you've got one problem, man. You ain't got a great mind. You ain't playing with a full deck. Because if you were, you'd have never signed for a match with the mighty Kamala, the Ugandan giant. Because, brother, I'm known as the genius of Mississippi. I'm the smartest man that ever walked out of that state. That's why I've got the biggest, the baddest, and the greatest man in professional wrestling. And Texas Tornado, he's going to show you why.
And remember, it all takes place on Sunday, July 12th at 7:30 p.m. in Toronto's Maple Leaf Garden. In the big main event, tag team action, Ultimate Warrior along with The Undertaker squaring off against Papa Shango and the Berserker. Big Boss Man, he's back in town, and he'll be out for revenge when he takes on Nails. Al Matador, Tito Santana, he'll have to be at his best when he goes against the Ugandan giant Kamala. Also in tag team action, Legion of Doom, Animal and Hawk taking on the Beverley Brothers. High Energy, they'll be there in one-on-one confrontations. Owen Hart taking on one half of the Nasty Boys and Knobs. Sags, the other half of Nasty Boys, takes on the other half of High Energy, the Birdman, Coco Beware. And also appearing on the spectacular card, the Texas Tornado, Kerry Von Erich. Remember, it all takes place on Sunday, July 12th at 7:30 p.m. in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. And be sure to join us tonight at 7 p.m. for the World Wrestling Federation. And now, let's go back to Gorilla Monsoon and the Brain.
Next week, right here, WWF Tag Champs, Buddy Incorporated.
And a special interview with Mr. Fuji's Big Berserker, Sword and All.
Four title holders, WWF Intercontinental Champ, Bret the Hitman Hart will be here.
And don't let this man put a curse on you. Papa Shango is here.
You won't want to miss this. In our special report, the WWF Champion, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. That and a whole lot more right here next week.
A man discovers a cure for his drinking problems in the Twilight Zone. Tonight at 8:30. Next on Channel 11, Women's Championship Basketball.
Violence is on the rise. Make yourself less vulnerable. Get Streetwise, a special report on assaults here on Channel 11.
Well, this July 1st party is shaping up to be the blast of the century. You guys pumped?
Well, to tell you the truth, given our history, we're a bit worried about our drummer.
Yeah, so we're holding backup auditions.
All drummers are invited.
You can be big.
You can be small.
You can be fire.
You can be ice.
Or lukewarm water.
Short hair.
Long hair.
Just one requirement, really. Got to be alive.
Well, you're going to get swamped. People are just dying to drum with you.
Well, that's just it.
Yeah, they do die.
Final attempt the interview. More to come.
This is the right time and the right place.
And now, during hot fun in the summertime, your Ontario Ford and Mercury dealer is the right place. Now, get Aerostar for just $15,891 with air, automatic, anti-lock brakes, and airbag. Or choose $1,250 cash back on all other Aerostars, including Aerosport and Eddie Bauer models. Aerostar, just $15,891 for a limited time at your Ontario Ford and Mercury dealers today.
Because it's the right time and the right place.
The Canadian College Basketball Championship is brought to you by your local bottler of Coca-Cola Classic. Can't beat the real thing.
For the game of the week. Today from Mohawk College in Hamilton, it's OCAA ladies basketball, and today the provincial championship featuring the pride of London, Ontario, the Fanshawe Falcons, and the pride of Etobicoke, the Humber Hunt. And this is Mohawk College, the scene of this afternoon's provincial championship in a battle of the birds, the Hawks and Falcons. It should be a great afternoon of basketball. Welcome back to Mohawk College, everyone. Paul Hendrick here. And what a tournament it has been for these two teams. The road to success, the final two, determined last night. Fanshawe upsetting the Seneca Scouts by 3 points to move into the championship game. And the Humber Hawks, a very easy winner of the home court Mohawk Lady Mountaineers. And as a result, our final here this afternoon. And we are back again with Wessex. And Wes, what a tremendous afternoon of basketball. We're going to see two different teams and two very different styles.
No question. Fanshawe like to play a very disciplined game. They like to get in their half-court game, control the ball, use their height, and get the stick-back points. On the other hand, the Humber Hawks, they'll use the whole 94 feet. They press the whole game. They like to get baskets in transition, and they'll hurt you on the turnovers.
So many outstanding players in this game, but we've got a couple to talk about. All-Canadian status for both these girls.
For Fanshawe, of course, they're led by the second-team All-Star. 12 points per game is the paint player inside. Very strong off the boards, and she'll rebound.